Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to make these two effects. Okay, let's start with the first one, the drone flying through a building and the arrow points on the balcony. To make a line which start and the end follows the certain point, we need to create a new shape layer. On this shape layer we need to take our pen tool, create whatever line you want and put effect beam onto it. The line is created. So we are going to change the color to white, softness to 0%. Length to 100%, take the beginning, put it here, and take the end and put it here. We're going to change the name to line, and as you can see, the line is created, but it doesn't follow these points. So we need to create a new null object, call it tracker one. Take our video clip, find the tracker here, click track motion. If you can see a tracker, it's down here. Window, tracker. We've selected video, we need to click track motion, just position, edit target, remember to have tracker one here. Put the tracker over this balcony. And click play. Okay, now we click apply, X and Y, and we created a tracker. You can see this null object follows this point. So we are going to expand our line, our effect beam, and find the ending point, because this is the ending point. We're going to open the position for tracker one, and with the pick whip tool we are going to connect these two values. As you can see, the ending point is taking position for tracker one, which is always this balcony. And now we are going to make the same for the start of the line. As I can see, the line is not perfect. Oh, great. Now we are going to create new null object, tracker 2, and with the video selected, we click track motion, make sure the tracker 2 is selected. This corner will be okay, make it to this corner where the beginning of the line is, and hit play. Apply, X and Y, and with here our starting point, tracker 2. Always remember to, when you pick whip values like this, to put your indicator at the beginning of the animation. So I'm going to connect it and stays here, and it stays here, so perfect. Now we want to make the text over this building, but as you can see, the building a little changes, so it's coming forward and little rotates. So if we put a text here, look what's gonna happen. And look, it flies away. So it also needs to stay in this place and change its size according to the size of the building. So we are going to create a third tracker. Click our video, track motion, and now we are going to select also rotation and scale. Make sure tracker 3 is selected, and as you can see, two points now are visible. So one point will be this point, and second point we can take this point. because this point needs to be visible all the way through the video. And these points are going to show how distance between these two points change. So as you can see, this point and this point will be still visible at the end of the video. So we are going to click play, apply X and Y. And now we can just pick whip our text and point it to a tracker 3. And voila. Also, we can make here a little arrow. So we are going to zoom a little, create a little triangle here. And we are going to this triangle point to the tracker 1. Voila. Okay, so with this effect, we want to highlight this parcel. To make it happen, we're going to use Mocha. At the beginning, we are going to copy our layer, click the second layer, and click Track in Boris FX Mocha. In our effect controls, Mocha AE shows up. We are going to click Mocha, and the new window is going to pop up. If you never used it before, make sure you have Workspace Essentials, and I'm going to walk you through what to do here. So here are the options what the Mocha FX needs to track. So for this effect, we are going to click the first 4. And over here we have our X-plane layer tool. So we're going to leave this one. And now we've clicked Z button. We can zoom a little onto this parcel and start drawing our property lines. Okay. And to stop creating the lines, we need to just click the right button on the mouse. As you can see, the corners are rounded. We don't want that because the corners of the parcel are 90 degrees. So we are going to highlight this one. Click Ctrl A, Command A on the Mac, and push a little these blue lines. So it's gonna create hard angles. And now we are going to click this button. As you can see, Mocha is tracking all the points. When, as you can see, when it goes wrong, we can stop it, fix it a little, and press play again. Looks great. So when you are happy with these outlines, just press save and exit this new window. Now we are going to expand our matte and click create EA masks. So now we have our parcel on the separate layer, as you can see here. And now to create these outlines, we are just going to select our layer with parcel. I'm gonna change that name, parcel, and to original, and click effect, generate stroke. As you can see, stroke generated over the mask. That looks great. And now we want to animate a little this line. So we are going to click the stopwatch on the end parameter and make it to 0. Great. To make it better, we're gonna ease it just by clicking F9. Great. To make a white highlight over this parcel, we are going just put effect hue and saturation over it. And just right before the line finishes, click stopwatch on the channel range and make master lightness a little higher. You can also ease that and let's see what's happening. Awesome. But we have one issue here. You can leave it as it is, but we can also create this house in front of this highlight and in front of this line. So we are going to copy our original, put it over and call it, for example, house. Now we are going to double click this house and open the layer house, little zoom in, and now we are going to use Rotobrush. If you never use the Rotobrush, it's the tool which allows you to put a certain object, certain moving object on a separate layer. As you can see, when it's green, I can select, for example, this house. Let's make it a little bit bigger. And now this pink line shows me what's gonna be on a separate layer. So this is going to be on a separate layer. I want to make it a little bit more here. And with pressed Alt option on the Mac, you can subtract like that. Green adds to the mask and the red subtracts from the mask. Now we are going to move a little forward. And now the propagation is started. So the program is frame by frame trying to follow the mask. I prefer to make a little like stops, not always full to the end, because when the mask in the middle miss something or take an additional object, it's gonna to ruin the whole propagation, and sometimes it takes a little time. So I always make like few frames and going to fast forward it. And now after everything is done and you are happy with the selection, just click freeze. We are going to turn off our layer and just see what's happening. We have our original layer down below. Now we have our parcel layer. And now we have our home. I think it looks great. And now we are going to see how it looks. Awesome. I hope you enjoyed it and see you in the next videos. Bye.